Many definitions of steady state will tell you that in is equal to out. However, this is only true under certain conditions, and the definition of steady state extends beyond this. The more correct definition of steady state is that process variables do not change with time. Shown here is a pipe with fluid flowing through it, where you can see a very repetitive motion of the dots floating across the screen. If we let each of these dots represent any process variable, such as mass, energy, entropy, pressure, temperature, volume, chemical composition, pH, density, viscosity, or anything else I might have forgotten, we see that over time the values remain constant throughout. The inlet and outlet remains the same, and at any given position, the number of dots remains the same. It's easy to convince ourselves here that this system is at steady state. In a second example, we see variables change over the length of a pipe. This could be due to a reaction causing the concentration, the pH or enthalpy of the material to change from left to right, or the pipe might be heated and the temperature increases or the viscosity changes, or something else happens where variables change across the process. It might be tempting to say that the inlet does not equal the outlet and therefore there is a change, and this is not at steady state. This would be incorrect. We need to go back to the formal definition of steady state, where process variables do not change with time, and expand this definition. What we need to do is look at a single location to determine if there are any specific changes at any given point over time. On the left-hand side of the pipe, the dots are always blue, and on the right-hand side of the pipe, the dots are always red. The definition of steady state refers to a specific location over time and not a change in location. A dot slightly to the left or slightly to the right might change color with the dot at a specific location, but this specific dot always stays the same color. A specific point highlighted here has the same color. As the dots move through, we can see that they do not change. And we can do this for a second point or a third point. For each specific point, and any other we choose, there's no change of the process variables over time, and therefore the system is at steady state. So again, steady state is when a process variable does not change with time. For a more mathematical definition, we can write this as ddt is equal to zero, where on the numerator we have any of the process variables that we've mentioned before: mass, energy, entropy, pressure, temperature, volume, and so on. At steady state, all of these variables would remain constant over time. Should just one change, the entire system is no longer at steady state. Two examples of how you would use steady state definition are the mass balance and the energy balance. Both of these equations have a ddt term in them. The mass balance has a mass term, while the energy balance has terms for internal energy, kinetic energy, and potential energy in the numerator. If the systems are at steady state, these terms would reduce to zero. Lastly, it is important to remember what system you have chosen. Steady state refers to how the material responds to your defined boundaries. For example, should you define a system as a moving boundary, such as a volume of fluid flowing through a plug flow reactor, this would result in a non-steady state scenario in a process that is at steady state. This is because a plug flow reactor is defined as being at steady state, but your frame of reference is moving, and we are changing concentration within your boundary over time, as your system moves through the reactor.